Hola, this is Dro, and welcome to my top 10 singles of 1976 countdown. The basic premise of this project is I went through Billboard's top 100 singles for the year 1976 and listened to all the singles and came up with a top 20 list, and then went back after a period of time and re-listened to the top 20 to come up with my top 10 singles for the year 1976. It's based solely on what I enjoy the most. So let's get to the countdown. Number 10 is Slow Ride by Foghat, written by Dave Peverett, singer and rhythm guitar player of Foghat. Was off of their fifth album, Fool for the City, and was Foghat's top single. The original LP version is 8 minutes and 14 seconds. The single version is 3 minutes and 56 seconds, truncated with a fade-out ending. I love this song. It's fantastic riffs, great guitar playing, catchy, and it's groovy. The main riff is one of those great riffs that every guitar player can't wait to learn when they start learning how to play. It's just a really cool song. Number 9 is Rock and Roll All Night, live version by Kiss. Written by Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley, the studio version was a minor hit, but the live version off the first Kiss Alive album was a bigger hit, and the version that is considered the classic one. It's one of the ultimate rock and roll party songs and a staple of Kiss and just fun as heck. Ace Frehley's guitar solo, while simple, is like so catchy and memorable and full of energy, and this is just high energy, good times rock and roll. Number 8, She's Gone by Daryl Hall and John Oates. Written by Daryl Hall and John Oates, released originally as a single in 1974, peaking at number 60. But after Sarah Smiles was a hit for Hall and Oates, this was re-released in a more pop radio-friendly edit and made it all the way to number 7 on the Hot 100 in 1976. John Oates, in a 2009 interview with American Songwriter, said that he was sitting down with his guitar and just had a chorus and brought it to Daryl Hall, and they worked on it and wrote the rest. This is a pretty emotional song, in my opinion. Be it the end of a relationship to the loss of a loved one, this song can apply to just about anyone and pull on your heartstrings in some way or another, in very real ways. Daryl Hall's singing is fantastic, the production is great, and it's just it's a really fantastic song. Number 7, Love Hurts by Nazareth, written by Felice and Boudelot Bryant, a husband and wife country music and pop songwriting duo. It was recorded by various groups including the Everly Brothers and Roy Orbison in the 1960s. The Nazareth version, though, is the most famous version. Dan McCafferty's vocals are like so great on this song. He's like almost over the top with his performance, but it works, and he really gets like this pain across in his vocals. Whether it's acting or he's channeling something, he really felt it feels genuine. And the guitar solo needs a mention here as well, because it's really effective yet simple solo, and it's one that I really enjoy a lot. It's a great song that still feels really fresh even today, in my opinion. Number 6, You'll Never Find Another Love Like Mine by Lou Rawls, Written by Kenny Gamble and Leon Huff, the producers behind the Philadelphia Sound. It was the breakthrough hit for Lou Rawls. Gamble and Huff wrote the song with Rawls' voice in mind. Gamble was going through a divorce from singer Dee Dee Sharp at the time, and the story in the song, Relationship at a Turning Point, the man won't beg the lady to stay, but lets her know that she's going to miss his love, is a reflection of that. Some might find this very questionable to have so high on this list, or to have it at all, but this is a song I've like heard my entire life. We had a Reader's Digest set of vinyl records that had top 10 hits for every year in the 1970s, and man, I used to hear this from childhood on, and this song always drew me in. The song is almost like a standard, but with a disco production. And to this day, I just am still like drawn to this song. I think it's a great pop song, and it'll always be a top classic with me. Number 5, Rhiannon by Fleetwood Mac. Written by Stevie Nicks, she has said the song is about a Welsh legend named Rhiannon and heavily influenced by the novel Triad by Mary Leader, about a woman named Bronwyn who's possessed by another woman named Rhiannon. Nicks said she found the name so pretty she wanted to write a song about a girl with the name, and that the song took 10 minutes to write. She researched the legend of the Welsh goddess and began developing a Rhiannon project for possibly a movie, musical, cartoon, or ballet. Several songs came out of this project, including Stay Away, Maker of Birds, and Angel. This is a great classic rock song. Fantastic melody, fantastic guitar riff, great vocals from Nicks, and the haunting atmosphere is really something special. Really great song. Number 4, Dream On by Aerosmith. Written by Steven Tyler, it was the second single off Aerosmith's 1973 debut album. It peaked at number 59 in 1973, but when re-released in 1976, it really took off and made it all the way to number 6 on the Billboard Hot 100. Tyler has said in interviews about the song, that the song is about the hunger to be somebody, chasing your dreams, and all the mess you have to put up with to get there. I love this song. It's an amazing song. Great melodies, great riffs, a ballad with great rock sections and the haunting melodies and drama upon drama. It really has everything, and it's another one of those songs like we keep running into here in 1976 list of songs that most guitar players try to learn when they're starting out. It's just fantastic, amazing songs. Number 3, The Boys Are Back in Town by Thin Lizzy, written by Phil Lynott, the bass player and lead singer of Thin Lizzy. This was Thin Lizzy's only U.S. top 40 hit. It's said to be inspired by the band's fans, who were mostly working class guys looking to have some fun and drink heavily. I love this song. First off, I'm a guitar player, so for very obvious reasons, this song has always been one of my all-time favorite rock songs. Figuring out the guitar harmony riff was one of those early breakthroughs in my guitar playing. I still remember taking a tape recorder, recording one of the guitar lines, and playing it back and playing the other guitar line over the tape recorder so I could do the riff, and like the thrill and excitement of that moment, like of hearing, you know yourself pulling off the harmony deal, is like, oh, it's very vivid in my head. It's like, ah, oh, the jolt you get from that. From, you know, at that moment, it was awesome. And this song is just, you know, an awesome, fun, all-time classic rock song with one of the greatest riffs ever. Number 2, Silly Love Songs by Paul McCartney and Wings, written by Paul and Linda McCartney. It was a response many feel to a comment by John Lennon, who claimed the only songs McCartney wrote for the Beatles were silly love songs. Another line of thought is that many music critics of the day accused McCartney of writing songs that were too lighthearted, and this was his reply to the critics. Whatever the theory one buys into, all I know is that this is an amazing song. It's unbelievably catchy, has these monster bass riffs, has these awesome harmony bits, awesome hooks left and right, with a slight disco drive going on, and it's just really amazing pop song. And it's another song I grew up with, probably also because of that Reader's Digest vinyl thing, and I've just always, you know, really loved this song. And there's also a really great live version of this song off the Wings Across America live album. From stuff I read around the internet, seems a lot of people don't care for the lyrics, but I really dig the message in this song. There's a place for all kinds of music, the sad, the dark, the angry, the lyrical, but you know, also the funny, fun, happy, and the love songs. There really is nothing wrong with wanting to fill the world with silly love songs. It's a great song. Number 1, Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen, is written by Freddie Mercury, and there isn't much I can say that will properly do this song justice. It is up there amongst the very top 10, 20 songs of all time by anyone, in my opinion. It literally has everything and anything, and is both one of the most musically complex and undeniably hook-filled and catchy songs of all time. It's epic, it's dramatic. It's part ballad, part ass-kicking rock and roll, part classical, just total awesome. There's no other song that could be number one but this one for 1976, in my opinion. It's one of the very greatest songs of all time by one of the very greatest bands of all time. And that's my top 10 singles of 1976. Thanks for listening, and be sure to give a like and also to subscribe to my channel for more top 10 lists in the future. Please share your top 10 list for the best singles of 1976 in the comments. Thanks so much for tuning in, and adios.